In the last video, I showed you how you can use print layouts to produce maps that differ from this map view that you have usually in QGIS by starting a new print layout. And now our actual map consists of more elements than just the background map and the points here. Usually you need a scale bar that people can identify what measurement in the printed map refers to what kind of size in on your map. Sometimes you are obliged to have a north arrow, and also currently we just have different colors here from our points, but we don't have an explanation which color means what, so you might like to have a legend here. Okay, let's start with the scale bar. So you all should have this button here for add scale bar. If I click that and click somewhere here and drag a frame, immediately a scale bar occurs. So this is the standard scale bar. You can see this alternating black and white boxes here. I can enlarge this box here, but nothing is changing with this scale bar. To change the amount of units that we see, you can see here on the right there is the option segments. Currently it says left 0 segments. If I add more, you can see that to the left more and more segments appear, which usually to the left gives you a smaller division of the individual segments, but we will not like to use that here. And if I enlarge to the right, you can see that more boxes appear here. So I move this legend to the lower right now, and also I can select different kinds of scale bars. So this is the simple frame, but I can change this to this double version, or have our units shown here on a line, or for example have this tick marks down, or have this tick marks up. I like to use this kind of scale bar because it's very subtle, it's not so much in the foreground, and it works quite well for scientific maps. Okay, that was the scale bar. Now let's add a north arrow, and in this newer version of QGIS you have a button here for north arrow. If I click that and drag a frame here, immediately a north arrow shows up here, and I can select different images for the north arrows here from our selection. In older versions of QGIS, the north arrow is not so much upfront available. To add here a north arrow, you have to select on add image, and then somewhere the selection of a different image pops up here, and again you can select the north arrow there. So it works essentially kind of the same. So I select this north arrow and I'm fine with that. So now I can make this bigger or larger. And also I can change the color. For example, I'd like this to be inverse, so I change the filling color to black and the color of the lines to white. And now I have here this kind of north arrow available. Okay, this is still quite big. I'll make it a bit smaller, so this should be enough. Last thing we would like to add here is a legend that gives the person that looks at the map an information what the different colors of our points mean. And to do so, I can click here on add legend, drag a frame here, and now a legend occurs where all the layers that are currently in our map are visible. But probably you will have more layers on your map window than you would like to see here. In that case, you can deselect this automatic update, and then you can click select one of these items here from the legend and say remove. So with that, this layer is gone. Also, we don't need an explicit information about our background map here. I remove that, and also I can remove this other background map here, and now we are left with the legends for this actual layer that we need the legend for. Also, currently the name of this item is according to the name of the layer. I can also change that by double clicking it and make this a bit nicer from the text. And now you can see here it says going out in Bern in a more or less pleasant way. And also, if I click here on this drop down, there is this last option here that would color anything that doesn't have a value. But since we don't have these NA values somewhere, we can also remove this from our legend. Okay, now we have this legend here. And it might be nice if we would have for the legend also a frame that goes around it. Currently it's just this white, then blends to the background map. We would probably like to have this with a frame, so that it's more differentiated from the background. To do so, I select this and go a bit down here to the element properties, and you will see here down there is a checkbox for frame. If I click that, now we have a frame around that. The same is true for the map itself. So if I select this and look down here, there's also the option frame, and with that also our map gets a frame around that. Last thing we probably would like to have is an attribution of the original data source. So I select text and click somewhere here, and if I just click and not make a frame, I'm asked for size of the box that I would like to use. Currently I'll just click on OK and make this scale this with the mouse, and now it says here lorem ipsum. This is just a placeholder. Now we can enter, for example, background map data from positron, and with that you can attribute the source of your background information. I will move this up here. Oh no, let's move the legend down here, and let's have that here. And in the next video, I will show you how you can make a small map in map that shows people that are not so accustomed to the geography of Switzerland where on earth we are actually having this specific map.